Today we got four different exercises we're going to be discussing for pitching. The first one we're going to talk about is load separation. We're going to be using a PVC pipe. You can use broomstick, your baseball bat, anything of length to put across your shoulders. The way this exercise is going to work, we're going to place the stick right behind our shoulders. Okay? The exercise, we're going to come set, we're going to lift, and the key point of our exercise is right here. Land and separate. I'm separating my upper half from my lower half. You can see my front foot, my knee is going towards the target. The PVC pipe has me closing my upper half. That's creating that separation, that rubber band effect in our body. You can also see I'm tilted. That tilt is very important. I'm looking over my front shoulder. And now I'm gonna use the PVC pipe to help pull down and then really get over my front leg and stabilize it. So I'm here, and I'm coming through. Okay, give you another viewpoint, do this way. Become set, get knee over knee, I'm corkscrewing, I'm leaning forward. I'm looking over my front shoulder, and then boom, coming through. Again, stabilizing that front leg. I'll give you another viewpoint. Here, land and separate. Coming on through. Okay, that is a load, land and separation drill. Incorporating a front side pull. Use the PVC pipe to pull down to then get over our front leg, allow our backside to come up and over. That's the first exercise for the pitching drill. The next exercise we're gonna talk about is getting over our front side and locking out that front leg, stabilizing it. We're gonna do it without the stick this time. We're gonna work here. I'm gonna feel my weight load into that back heel. My shoulders are tilted, and I'm just getting over that front foot. Boom, feel yourself. Okay, here, boom. Stabilizing that front leg, boom. Again, chest is over. See, I'm working hard to stabilize that front leg. Here, okay, one more. Load it into that back glute and getting over that front leg. Those are the two drill exercises that we're gonna discuss. The next drill exercise we're gonna talk about is for our breaking balls. We're gonna simply just use a bottle. This is a very old school technique, which I love. It's a great way to get a visual and feedback of getting your fingers on top of the ball, more of a 12-6 with the hours and a clock. So the way we use this exercise is you just put your two fingers, obviously that you would use for your breaking ball. And the way this exercise is gonna work, I'm gonna demonstrate throwing it in a net, but I'm gonna get in this position here and I'm just gonna simulate coming through. You can see I'm leading here, my hand, my fingers are on top, and I'm flipping the bottle, 12-6. Okay, so I'm gonna give you a little visual. Here, and you can see, it goes end over end. I'll throw one this way. See, I'm here, and I'm throwing it end over end. Again, it's not a crazy drill, right, by no means. However, it is a drill that is great for just getting comfortable with our fingers being on top of the ball. The next exercise we're gonna talk about is just grabbing a baseball and working our changeup grip. So the way this exercise is gonna work, again, you remember in our previous videos, we talked about grabbing a two-seam fastball and working our changeup off of that grip. That way they mimic each other as much as possible when you're going to release. So the way this exercise is gonna work, I'm simply gonna grip the ball with my throwing hand, and I'm just gonna work on rotating my fingers inward, okay? That helps with pronation of the baseball to then really get it to sink and dive even more. Some people talk about really pronating their arm. I think, you know, that's just a preference. One of the easiest ways to get more bite and movement is really just spinning my fingers and getting comfortable. So I just simply put the ball in my hand, and you can see I'm working on spinning my fingers to the inside part of the ball. Again, very basic exercise, but again, something to create more spin, more depth, more movement on a pitch that's minimal stress and very effective. As you older you get, you'll learn more about finger pressure, stuff like that. And again, that's stuff that you can do with just rolling fingers as well on your pitches. So those are the pitching drills for the day.